With today's spiralling grocery prices, it's insane that so many of us rely entirely on the supermarkets for all our fruit and veg. Especially when you can get some for free. Sometimes it's under our noses. Not just wild food in the hedgerows, but cultivated food in our cities. The busy streets of Sheffield, where children at this daycare centre are tucking into just-picked, locally grown apples. All the fruit given to this and many other centres is free and grown within the city. It's part of a new and growing project called Abundance.
Wow. How many trees are there here? I can see half a dozen, nearly.
Yeah, about that.
It's a non-profit-making scheme set up to harvest Sheffield's glut of unpicked and unloved fruit.
Look at that colour. Gorgeous, eh?
Absolutely beautiful.
I've joined founder Stephen Watts at a patch of wasteland that he now calls the Garden of Eden.
Do you find wherever you are in the city now, you've always got your eye open for new trees? Peripheral tree vision going on.
It's not only peripheral tree vision, it's kind of almost psychic tree awareness. In that, okay. In that you suddenly think, I'm going to wander down this road, oh, and look, here's a big fruit tree.
It's like you've been drawn to
the tree. The tree finds you almost. It's,
really?
That's what it seems to be, yeah.
Excellent. I've already got three different types of apple on the go here. Mm-hmm. They're all really nice. An explosion of apple-y flavours. Quite a good haul from one tree, isn't it? And the one in about an hour, too.
And you don't need to be psychic. Stephen has spent 3 years mapping the city's fruit trees so that more and more people can find their own free fruit. And it's just the beginning.
Any idea how many more might be out there in the city, just waiting to be picked?
Well, we've actually got about 250 on the map. You could potentially add two more noughts on the end of that.
Really?
Yeah, potentially.
Okay. Are we going to shake? That works, doesn't it? That's a corker.
After only a few hours of picking, we have loads of apples and a far greater variety than you'd find at any supermarket. But it's all taken its toll on happy scrumper JJ.
You fancy another apple, JJ?
Oh, no way, yeah.
You didn't eat a Bramley, did you?
No, I've been drinking a lot of apple juice and it's making my stomach acidy.
You've just been out and scrumped too many apples.
Yeah.
You're painful, is it?
Yeah.
Try not to laugh. It'll only make it worse.
Those of us without scrumper's tum sit down to sample the pick of the local bunch.
So we've got Fillingham Pippin.
Yes.
Ribston Pippin. Flower of the town, and they're all old Yorkshire varieties, some of them very hard to get hold of.
I want to start with flower of the town because it's a very, very unusual, rare variety.
That is really nice.
It's got an almost a lemony kind of...
I was going to say citrus.
Citrusy thing. Mm.
But also scented, isn't it? Sherbety.
Pineapple, I reckon.
It's like a hint of caramel. Or...
I had a really good skin on this one.
It tastes like apple pie.
Cider. This'll make a good juice.
There are over 2,000 British varieties of apple. Yet in most supermarkets, you'd be lucky to find more than three.
It's always struck me that towns and city councils plant so many trees.
Yeah.
And they plant so few edible trees.
Yeah, and they plant
and
all...
It's so wrong, isn't it?
They plant cherries which specifically don't fruit because they just want the flowers or whatever. And actually, the fruit's going to make it so much better because people can come and eat it.
Why not? I'll drink to that. It's unbelievably nice. Wow.
What's on, JJ?
Five, man.
That is an apple-y holy communion. That's very good. The apple is the quintessential British fruit, and for centuries, almost everyone, whether they lived in the city or the country, could get hold of them pretty much for free. Wouldn't it be great to get back to that? Apples for everyone, no money changing hands.